name is Elizabeth Shehiza. I'm a care for orphans, the orphans which were left by my brothers and niece. Yeah.
So in total, how many children do you care for?
Oh, like 12. In 1993, I lost a brother of mine, and I was carrying him without the training or whatsoever. And unfortunately, he died the same year.
In 1993. How many children did he leave for you?
Four children. Two girls and two boys. In 2004, I lost my niece. She also left me with four children, three girls and one boy. But at least I had a clue of caring more than as I had in 1993.
Because people started already talking about HIV and AIDS. Yeah.
And her husband had already died the past year, 2003. So 2004, herself also was affected by the disease and started getting sick, and he died the same year. She died the same year. In 2006, I lost also a brother, leaving behind again four children, one girl and three boys.
And were your brothers married or they had wives?
Yeah, they had, their wives are still alive.
Hmm.
Mm.
One of them or both of them, are they infected or?
They are all infected.
They're infected, so are they under medication?
Yeah. Right?
You talked about you were struggling to do the care before when your brother was alive, your first brother was alive in 1993.
Mm.
Are you trained now, or you have the knowledge in terms of providing care to the sick?
Well, I'm trained now, but having already got the most of the knowledge, but then it was the added knowledge, because the training I got from our mother was more exposure than what I had really known. So it's an added advantage.
Maybe you can tell us, what are you doing now after being trained? You have already lost your brothers, you have their wives taking the medications. What are you doing now after being trained?
I'm just doing the counseling. Like when I see someone doesn't understand what HIV is, I just give the counseling.
Mm-hmm.
And I assist my neighbors. Whenever I see them with signs of HIV/AIDS, I just advise them to go to hospital and maybe have some medication. For medication for prolonging, because we hear that there are medicine for prolonging life. Even if you have HIV/AIDS, you can live longer.
So what kind of message do you want to bring to the audience, the public, about this kind of support? You were working, you received pension, and in your group maybe there are some people, older people, who are doing the same role of care. They don't have pension, they don't have anything. Or what would you like to say to the
maybe
government,
to the government, the to the government? They should see how possible it will it be to give at least a bit of assistance to those who are caring the children, and to my fellow old people.
Mm-hmm.
They should try their best to take care of the children, and if possible to take them to school, because sometimes if God gives us a life, the children will also help us.
Mm-hmm.
When they get their own
jobs,
and when they get their own income, they won't forget us.
Yeah, do you think that is possible for a person with no income? What do you suggest?
Well, that they should be given even loans, grants,
mm-hmm.
whatever which is really is applicable to be given to them. It's a bit easier when you have your pension.
Mm.